I declare the 7th annual convocation of XIM University open.
Please remain standing for the prayer song. You may be seated. We welcome our chief guest and convocation speaker, Shri Harshpathy Singhania, President, All India Management Association, Vice Chairman and Managing Director, JK Paper Limited. We welcome Father Jerome Kutina, SJ, Chairman, Board of Governors. We welcome Sri Rajiv Kaul, Chairman Emeritus, Board of Governors. We welcome Father Anthony R. Overy, Vice Chancellor, XIM University. We also extend a warm welcome to all the members of the Board of Governors, XIM University, faculty and staff members of both the campuses, members of the media, and my dear graduating students. I now request Professor Sridhar Kumar Das, Dean Academics, Xavier Institute of Management, to deliver the welcome address.
Good afternoon, respected chief guest and convocation speaker, Sri Harshpati Singhania, President, All India Management Association, Vice Chairman and Managing Director, JK Papers Limited. Respected Father Jerome Kutina SJ, Chairman, Board of Governors, XIM University. Respected Sri Rajiv Kaul, Chairman Emeritus, Board of Governors, XIM University. Respected Father R. Ubari SJ, Vice Chancellor, XIM University. Respected Father E.A. Augustine SJ, Registrar, XIM University. Respected board members of XIM University, my dear dean colleagues, office bearers of XIM University, faculty and staff members of XIM University, members of print and electronic media, graduating students and their proud parents, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of XIM University family and on my personal behalf, I extend a warm welcome to each one of you to the 7th convocation of XIM University. Past 18 months has been tough for all of us. Despite the challenges, we have finished our academic calendar on time. Our faculty and staff members deserve credits for the same. The current challenges also helped us to innovate and prepared us for the future. Today is a milestone for all of us as we adopt our new identity, new vision, new mission, and new values to face the challenges ahead. What we do today will define us tomorrow. I hope we, as a community of XIM University, can make a small difference in the society that we live in. You as graduating batch will also define us in future, and I look forward to your success as you embark on your new phase of life. I wish all happiness and good health for all of you. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Sridhar Das. I now request the Vice Chancellor, Father Anthony R. Overy, to present the Vice Chancellor's report.
Honorable Chief Guest Sri Harshpati Singhania, President, All India Management Association, and Vice Chairman and Managing Director, JK Paper Limited, Father Jerome Kutina, Chairman, Board of Governors, Sri Rajiv Kaul, Chairman Emeritus, esteemed members of the Governing Board of XIM University, deans and my faculty colleagues, staff members, graduating students, parents, dignitaries and invitees, members of the press and media, ladies and gentlemen. I welcome you all to the 7th convocation of XIM University, Bhubaneswar. Before I begin my convocation address, highlighting various aspects of the university, what we have achieved together, I would like to draw your attention to the transformation that Exim University has undergone since the past convocation. We have been able to harness the rich legacy of XIMB with our university and are now XIM University. The old and the new integrating to create a richness of growth and development despite the challenges. Despite the waves of pandemic and students unable to come back to physical classes, we have taken care to ensure that the assurance of learning and the teaching-learning process continued unaffected. I take this opportunity to remember those colleagues, friends, and family whom we have lost due to the pandemic since the last convocation. We remember them with a heart full of warm memories and deep gratitude for their lives and their works. We also remember our COVID warriors who continue to strive each day and night to ensure we are all safe. At this juncture, I would like to profusely thank the members of Board of Governors of XIM University for their unstinted support, which has enabled us to scale new heights of transformation and growth. I thank the members of Board of Management, Academic Council, and the Finance Committee, faculty, staff, students, SEC members, alumni, and the Jesuit community for their support and untiring commitment to this institution. With a heavy heart today, we remember Father E. Abraham, who was the former director of Xavier Institute of Management, former director of XLRI Jamshedpur, and advisor to the Vice Chancellor XIM University, who passed away to his heavenly abode. We are richer today for his immeasurable contributions to this institution and Jesuit business education in India and abroad. My heartfelt condolences on the passing away of Dr. Sangamitra Mohanty, who was a member of the Board of Governors of XIM University and passed away due to COVID. We also remember Professor Deepak Misra and Mr. Sandos Pradhan, whom we lost during this pandemic. You would be happy to know that the entire faculty and staff of XIM University have donated one day's salary amounting 12.5 lakhs to the Chief Minister's Relief Fund to support the COVID-19 relief work. Apart from that, our students have distributed household kits at a cost of Rs 700 to 2,000 poor families near in and around our campuses who are affected due to the lockdowns during this pandemic. My heartiest congratulations to the graduating students of 2019-21 batch who have passed with flying colors under these trying circumstances. There are 7 students who are graduating from the doctoral program, 374 students in the MBA BM program, 23 in 1 year MBA executive program, 3 in executive MBA business analytics, 4 in global MBA program, 129 students in MBA human resource management program, 108 in MBA RM program, 26 in MBA sustainable management program, and 8 in MBA in urban management program, 14 in Masters in Business Finance, 2 in MA in Mass Communication, and 5 in MTech program. A total of 703 students are graduating from doctoral and master's program this evening. We have wonderful news coming from the School of Computer Science. The first batch students of School of Computer Science for both PG and UG programs are graduating this evening. In the undergraduate program, we have 25 BCom, 36 BBM students, 8 in BSc Sustainable Development, 18 in BSc in Mass Communication, 10 in BSc Economics, 11 in BSc in Computer Science and Engineering are graduating. A total of 108 students are graduating from UG programs this evening. With 12 schools, 6 centers of excellence and 3 research journals, we have developed a robust foundation for education and research. We admitted 641 students in PG, 552 students in UG programs, and 10 students in doctoral program. A total of 1200 plus students have been admitted in the academic year of 2020 to 21 at XIM University. We have provided 104 students with merit scholarship, 7 students with SCST economically backward and minority category scholarships, as well as scholarship to 9 students in doctoral programs. A total of 120 students have been provided scholarships, which is the highest provided by the university since its inception 1987. It is our small contribution to supporting education and ensuring support to meritorious students. A series of leadership talks, workshops, webinars, symposiums have been organized, which are provided in the annual report. I won't take much time providing the details in this speech. You would be happy that Xavier Institute of Management, XIM University, has been ranked at the 31st rank among business schools in India under the management category of Ministry of Education's NIRF India Rankings 2020. Apart from that, XIM University has been awarded the CSR Top University of India Award for the year 2020. It has also been conferred CSR Excellence in Education Award and ranked 10th among India's top 50 private state universities in the Outlook iCare University ranking. A total of 17 faculty and 5 non-teaching staff have joined the XIM University in the last academic year. 6 faculty members were awarded their PhDs, and Professor Prahlad Mishra, Professor Bibhu Prasanth Patra, Mr. Ramesh Chandra Swain, and Mr. Satyanand Panda retired from their services at the university after decades-long relationship and contributions with the university. Our faculty's research and publication reached historic levels of excellence. Our faculty published 8 books, 29 book chapters, 14 cases, 130 articles in international journals, 63 articles in national journals, presented 8 papers at international conferences, and 3 papers at national conferences. Despite the challenge of the pandemic, we had 374 students of MBA BM, 130 students of MBA HRM, 108 of MBA RM, 26 in MBA SM, and 8 in MBA UMG, and 14 in MBF programs secured their final placements for the batch of 2019-21. For the summer internships for batch 2020-22, 356 in MBA BM, 119 in HRM, 74 in RM, 19 in MBA SM, 19 in MBA EMG, and 13 in MBF secured summer internships. Many congratulations to our students who actively participated in various international, national, state level competitions and won many prizes. Our alumni have done exceedingly well in their professional and personal lives. Some of their achievements are mentioned in annual report, which I encourage all of you to go through. There are 7 staff members who are being appreciated for their meritorious service of 25 years to the university today. There are also 7 staff members being appreciated for 15 years of meritorious service to the university as well. As I close, let me confess to our graduating students that since March 2020, both at a professional and personal level, the world has undergone a massive change due to the pandemic. But it has also unlocked opportunities. Never lose focus of that. While mountains do stop our path, tunneling through the rocks will lead us to the destinations of higher heights. My best wishes to all of you as you graduate today. Keeping pace with these changing and challenging times, we at XIM University have been forging ahead with your support, guidance and best wishes. I assure you that XIM University will continue its efforts to ensure that the best of values and education gets imparted, and we build the citizens of tomorrow with humility in our hearts and grace of God on us. Thank you. May God bless all of us.
Thank you, Father Anthony Poveri, for presenting the Vice Chancellor's report. I now request the Chairman, Father Jerome Kutina, to deliver the Chairman's address.
The Chief Guest for the 7th convocation of XIM University, Shri Harshpati Singhania, the members of the Board of Governors of XIM University, Mr. Rajiv Kaul, Vice Chancellor Father Anthony Wari, Registrar Father Augustine, who could not be here today, the academic deans, the eminent guests, the faculty, the staff, the parents and family members of the graduating students, members of the press, and my dear graduating students. On behalf of the Board of Governors, I extend a warm welcome to all of you on the occasion of the 7th annual convocation of XIM University. I, on behalf of the Board of Governors, the faculty, the staff, and all of us present here, and those viewing the program virtually, congratulate all the graduating students on your successful completion of the postgraduate and undergraduate courses. We are indeed proud of your achievements. Today marks an important and significant milestone in your life's journey, dear students. We know the annual and convocation ceremony usually the highlight of any university. The pandemic has turned the world upside down, and you have to face the disappointment of missing the convocation in person. Given these limitations, we can only be satisfied with the virtual convocation. That virtual reality has become the working reality, the new normal. The pandemic has also has given us the opportunity to develop skills in this unprecedented situation. The competencies and the skills you acquired during your days at the university will be put to test at these times in your process of informed decision-making, creative problem-solving, and above all, your adaptability and resilience. These skills remain a priority for all students. As young corporate leaders, constantly reorient your ways of thinking and act suitably. You now have the advantage to learn and adapt to the new norms emerging in the workplace. Do not forget that what university has taught you are all tools to cope with situations, new situations. It much depends on your adaptability. Then the responsibility is on you to steer your potential for not merely projecting the better path in your life, but also to create a path for others to follow, and inspiring and enabling people to live extraordinary lives. Keep in mind the values XIM University stands for: integrity, excellence, inclusiveness, compassion and sustainability, ensure ethics and integrity in your life and your work, in whatever you do, if you want to succeed. Success without integrity is failure. Warren Buffett may have said it best. If you are looking for people to hire, look for three qualities: integrity, intelligence, and energy. If you don't find the first one, the other two will kill you. Yes, unless you instill these habits, strengthening yourself morally in your life and in your business dealings, all your learning schooled at exam university will have no value. Dear students, as you step out into the world as world leaders, please have in mind your responsibilities clear, the responsibilities to your country and your family. It is your obligated duty to remember the poor, the less privileged, and the marginalized in whatever you do. These obligations will give you a sense of direction and purpose in life. Today, as you leave the university, do whatever you can for your alma mater. Much of our success, future success, depends on your accomplishments. And we here would love to continue our relationships in the days ahead. Do what you can for your university. I also take this opportunity to congratulate the Vice Chancellor for the Tony Award and the entire administrative and academic team who have discharged their responsibilities to the best of their abilities. Our sincere appreciation to all the distinguished individuals and the visiting faculty members who have shared their valuable skills and knowledge with our students. J.R.D. Tata had a friend who used to say that he misplaces and loses his pen very often. He used to use only very cheap pens so that he did not worry about losing them. He was worried about this habit of carelessness. One day J.R.D. suggested to him to buy the costliest pen he could afford and see what happens. He did that and he purchased a 22-carat gold cross pen. 6 months later, J.R.D. met him and asked him if he continues to misplace his pen. His friend said that he is very careful about his expensive pen, but he was very surprised how he had changed. J.R.D. explained to him that the value of the pen made all the difference, and there was nothing wrong with him as a person. This is what happens in our lives. We are careful with things which we value most. If you value your degree, education, you'll honor and live by the values of exam university and shall always strive to apply your knowledge for the betterment of the society. I would like to end my address with a quote by Christopher Reeve. So many of our dreams at first seem impossible, then they seem improbable, and then when we summon the will, they soon become inevitable. I wish each one of you every success and God's abundant blessing. Thank you one and all.
Thank you, Father Jerome Kutina, for your encouraging address. I now request the Chairman Emeritus, Sri Rajiv Kaul, to deliver his address.
our distinguished chief guest, Mr. Harshpati Singhania, Vice Chairman and Managing Director, JK Paper Limited, and President, All India Management Association, Father Jerome Kutina, our Chairman and also Father Provincial, Father Anthony Uvery, our Vice Chancellor, Deans of the Schools and Controller of Examinations, members of our faculty, the graduating classes of 2021. I know you are present virtually, but really, I mean, we know you are with us in heart and spirit. It is with the greatest of pleasure that I extend my personal welcome to all of you on this very happy day when 812 students of our graduating classes of 2021 are given recognition for their hard work, persevering effort, and indeed success. It is today that all of you, my young friends, participate in this landmark event, albeit virtually, as you enter the new exciting real world, one of challenges as also opportunities. In fact, today's pandemic is perhaps the biggest challenge that we are all facing to date in our lives. And I really do hope that in future, none of you, and indeed none of us, have to face such a challenge ever again. Anyway, may I once again extend my warmest of congratulations and request the entire people in this hall to give them the recognition that they deserve. Please do join me. It's also a very special privilege for me to welcome our chief guest, Mr. Harshpati Singhania, a most accomplished and indeed dynamic corporate leader of our country. A thought leader, a leader who motivates, a leader who inspires, a leader who listens and decides, a leader who empowers his team, and a leader with a clear vision. But above all, an outstanding leader who is full of humility. Harsh, you honor us with your presence here today. Ladies and gentlemen, please do join me in giving him the rich applause he truly deserves. Thank you, Harsh, for being with us. When I say all these qualities of his, let me tell you how I've got to know him. I've got to know him and I've seen him when he was initially the president of FICCI, right? And FICCI, as you know, is an apex chamber of commerce and industry in our country. I come from the rival camp, which is called CII. And all I say is seeing him working the way he did, showing and displaying many, many of the traits, the positive traits that I've talked about, I said, thank God that I was president of CII perhaps 12 years before he was president of FICCI. So I had much less competition. So thank you for that, Harsh, as well. He has also grown JK Paper, which he leads today, from one factory in Orissa. In fact, it's an extremely large employer, and perhaps, I don't know, maybe 15 or 20,000 people have their livelihood as a result of his operations in Orissa. But during his leadership, he expanded it, and he expanded it in a very novel and unique fashion, a fashion which, in fact, contributes a lot to society, because he took over two companies which had gone down under, one from BIFR and the other under the new NCLT program of restructuring. And he's revived these companies, and even the company he took over, I think just 2 or 2.5 years ago, is now showing a bottom line profit. So he has this unique leadership ability and unique vision of turning around things which others could not run. So Harsh, this is yet another of your wonderful qualities. He is leading today IMA in truly exemplary fashion. He has, just like we in XIMB have given ourselves a new mission, a new vision, we've redefined our values. In IMA, he's just embarked in partnership with McKinsey, a new futuristic IMA, which in the years ahead, we'll see the All India Management Association moving from strength to strength in the years ahead, contributing to management, not just of colleges and universities, but indeed to augmenting the leadership and skills of the working manager. And Harsh, for this, we thank you, because we are ourselves in the field of educating leaders for tomorrow. With these words, friends, I welcome all of you as well. This is perhaps the smallest physical meeting that I've attended here, but indeed, if you include all the parents and children and our graduating classes of 2021 who are watching it, it certainly won't be the smallest. Indeed, it will be the largest. May I, with these words, thank all of you once again and request my dear friend and a person I admire, Mr. Harsh Pati Singhania, to deliver to all of us his convocation address. Over to you, Harsh.
Thank you, sir. Father Jerome Coutina, Chairman Board of Governors, XIMB. Sri Rajiv Kaul, Chairman Emeritus. Father Anthony R. Obari, Vice Chancellor. Members of the Board of Governors, XIM, Bhubaneswar University, faculty, parents of the graduating students, and most importantly, dear graduating students. I am delighted to participate in the convocation of XIM University, Bhubaneswar today, and feel privileged to have been asked to be the chief guest at the graduating ceremony of this premier institution. May I take the opportunity at the outset of expressing my appreciation to Chairman Emeritus Sri Rajiv Kaul. Sir, you have been very kind and generous with your words, but let me also say that I am not exactly the person you described. It is your generosity, your spirit and friendship, you know, which makes you say this. And if I may add, on a personal note, I have known your Chairman Emeritus even longer than he recalls. I remember him being a family friend, coming home to dinners that our family and my father would host, and the Fiki relationship, of course, came in later on. Thank you very much for asking me to be here. Chairman, Board of Governors, the Vice Chancellor, and all the other faculty members, it's an absolute honor for me to be here today. Thank you. But ladies and gentlemen, in a short span of time, XIM University has gained recognition as a premier business school of the country. I was happy to know that in the Outlook iCare Academic Ranking 2020, your university has been ranked amongst the top 10 private state universities in India. Congratulations. First of all, let me congratulate all the 812 graduating students. This must be a moment of great joy and happiness in your life, as the long years of academics come to fruition. You've invested a lot in your education, and people have invested in you. It is a moment for pride, of pride for you, as much as it is for your teachers, parents, and all those who have contributed in shaping your life so far. Today marks a significant milestone in your life's journey, the beginning of your career. However, I have some news for you. You are not yet done with universities and learning. You are now entering the university of life. The personal attributes that got you here, passion, commitment, tenacity, and an open mind to learn, will be important throughout your lives. Nurture this, as these are even more important than what you have learned in class. This occasion is aptly called commencement in the US, because you are commencing your journey of translating your education for the benefit of the world. Every graduate here today has the training and talent to succeed. But do you have the stomach to fail? There are few things more liberating in this life than having your worst fear realized. You've got to find what you love. And the only way to be truly satisfied is to do what you believe is great work. And the only way to do great work is to love what you do. There's a saying that if you do what you love, you'll never work a day in your life. The process of transition may pose some challenges, but the training you have received at this premier institute will give you the confidence to overcome them. Don't be afraid to fail. One of my early lessons when I joined work early on was when a senior colleague in our organization told me, "For God's sake, have the courage to fail." And I was not sure what he meant. But then he went on to his next sentence and said, "Otherwise, you'll never take decisions fearing failure." Dream big, but also have big goals. As without goals, dreams mean nothing. Learn from every mistake, because every experience, encounter, and particularly your mistakes are there to teach you and force you into being more who you are. The beauty is that through disappointment, you can gain clarity. And with clarity comes conviction and true originality. Dreams are a great test, because the dream is going to test your resolve, and it will allow you to get over your fear and go forward, no matter what obstacles are thrown in your path. Steer your ship into the choppy seas. Look for the rough spots, the problems that seem too big, and the complexities that other people are content to work around. It's in those places that you will find your purpose. As the great Mahatma Gandhi said, and I quote, "A man is but the product of his thoughts. What he thinks, he becomes," unquote. Well, let me share with you a personal anecdote here. How my late grandfather, Lala Lakshmipat Ji Singhania, then only in his early 30s, realized his dream of becoming the first manufacturer of aluminum from Indian bauxite in 1944, which was the birth of the Aluminium Corporation of India. It was no easy task, as aluminium was virtually the monopoly of an international cartel then. To make matters worse, World War II had broken out, and the orders for machinery that he placed with the Czechoslovakian manufacturers were destroyed by the enemy. The Czech engineers who were here in India to set up the plant were arrested, as we were under British rule then, and Czechoslovakia was part of the German Empire by that time. But he was not one to be intimidated and ordered new machinery from alternate suppliers in the UK. Even the initial fears of the engineers that the new plant could explode upon startup, as there was no technology supplier, was pacified by him when he decided to be personally present in the furnace room when the switch went on. It was this indomitable spirit, unassailable belief, and unflinching determination that after a long struggle of over 5 years, his dream ultimately came true. Moving on, similar enterprise was shown by later generations when my uncle, the late Sri Harishankar Singhania, whom you knew very well, Rajiv, introduced radial tire technology for the first time in India, way back in 1977. Today, I'm happy to share with you the JK Tire, which is a pioneer in the radial tires and currently is the market leader in truck and bus radial segment in this country. Working really hard is what successful people do. The chances you take, the people you meet, the people you love, the faith that you have, all these are going to define your life. Work hard and amazing things will happen. It's there that you can make your greatest contribution. If you haven't found it yet, keep looking. As with all matters of the heart, you'll know when you find it. We don't plan to fail, but we fail to plan. Every failed experiment is one step closer to success. Take your chances professionally. The choices you make will define who you are. Some failure in life is inevitable. It is impossible to live without failing at something unless you live so cautiously that you might as well fail by default. In fact, there is no such thing as failure. It's just life trying to move us in another direction. Thomas Edison conducted 1,000 failed experiments. Did you know that? I didn't know that because the 1,001st was the light bulb. Every failed experiment is one step closer to success. And we welcome you, dear students, as our next generation of managers and leaders, and await with bated breath to see your contributions in shaping the future of our country and indeed of the world. Perhaps every generation believes that it lives in special times, and perhaps every cohort of graduates is told just that at ceremonies like this. However, the sheer pace of change, coupled with the vast amount of knowledge and information available today, is unprecedented. Technology is rapidly changing the world of business, bringing about major transformations and disruptions. Without technology, no people or client services can be successfully fulfilled. The only way to stay ahead is to constantly evolve and stay relevant in this rapidly changing world. If you don't keep learning and reinventing yourself, how will you reinvent the businesses that you lead? According to a research by the Harvard Business Review, the work-related knowledge that a university student acquires will have a shelf life of 5 years. I'm sorry to say that, but that's what HBR says. As the sell-by date on skills shortens, new tasks, titles, and even careers are being created. Most of the 20 fastest growing jobs in the US did not even exist 5 years ago. Knowledge has to be improved, challenged, and increased constantly, or it vanishes. Again, to quote Lala Lakshmipatji, who used to say, it is not only machinery that becomes obsolete. One has to guard against obsolescence of the mind, unquote. Automation and robotics are helping businesses to become more sophisticated and seamlessly participate in key functions. Existing business models are being disrupted and new business models are being created, along with new roles and the need for new expertise. You have to be proactive, continuous learners to keep pace with the evolving technological landscape. Agility and adaptability are two important traits of today's successful leaders. This has been especially relevant during the current turbulent times of the COVID-19 pandemic that has taught the world to stay alert and responsive and adapt to the unexpected and changing conditions. The post-COVID-19 world has brought lasting changes that would have been considered impossible earlier. For this to happen, it is very important to have an entrepreneurial mindset. No matter what profession you choose, the ability to think and act entrepreneurially will be critical for success. Not everybody would end up as an entrepreneur. Many of you may be working for a company or an institute, but whatever you do, you have to act as if it is your own enterprise. You cannot just plan and hope to have a successful career, but must always be prepared to seize opportunities that come your way. And for that, you need to have an entrepreneurial mindset. Better performance comes from benchmarking with people, organizations, and nations that are better than us. Once you start benchmarking and competing with the global best, the next step for you is to aim to be the leader there. Every day, in whatever you do, just ask how you can make it better. It is only through your performance that you can translate your aspirations to actions. That performance leads to recognition, which in turn leads to respect. Respect leads you to power, the power to change the world. Aspirational performance requires that you create aspirational targets and work hard, fast, smart, honestly, and I will repeat honestly, and in a disciplined manner over a long period of time to achieve these. Don't let the noise of others' opinions drown out your own inner voice. And most importantly, have the courage to follow your heart and intuition. Organizations today are looking for people who are full of ideas and can think of new ways to achieve the desired outcome. Knowing who you are will help you when it's time to struggle for what you believe in, whether it's the job you want or the people who mean the most to you, and fight for the kind of world you want to live in. It will help when people say that's impossible or you can't do that. If you take the unexpected opportunities when they come up, if you know yourself, and if you fight for what you believe in, I can promise you, you will live a life that is rich with meaning. By now, you may have a fair idea of what you want to do. You may naturally want to get rich, make fortunes, and get famous. But even if you don't, it does not really matter. Find the pursuit that will energize you, consume you, and become an obsession. Each day, you must be brimming with relentless enthusiasm. But don't just aspire to make a living, aspire to make a difference. The relentless drive to achieve your goal is the single most important ingredient for success, as it overrides both talent and resources. However, it is also equally important to remain humble and grounded in life. Values are essential pillars of life and should never be compromised on. Businesses built on values survive longer and flourish better. The world needs your talent, but it also needs your gifts, whether it is your patience, kindness, unbound love, or a big heart to help those less fortunate. Whatever gift you have, find a purpose to do well with it. The smallest of gestures matter. But there's a difference between gifts and choices. Cleverness is a gift. Kindness is a choice. Be the first to congratulate others on their success, or be the first to console them when they face adversity. Try and create the world you want to live in. The good feeling that you get from helping others, nothing's better than that. While ambition gives you wings to fly, humility gets you grounded, ensuring you never lose touch with yourself. Whatever your professional goals, wherever you live, whoever you are, there are ways, big and small, that you can participate in the world being a better place for everybody. Make this world more sustainable and livable for future generations. If you can't do the little things right, you will never do the big things right. You inherit a world that has already proven that progress is possible. And that progress didn't happen by accident or fate. It was the result of people just like you who made a commitment that whatever else they did with their lives and careers, they would contribute to the shared mission of propelling us all forward. There is no question that you have a role to play, whether it's now or in the future. Espouse a professional and ethical attitude in your work-life journey and try to give back to society. The key to success, the key to happiness, is opening your mind and your heart to love, spending your time doing things you love with people you love. The challenge for your generation, dear students, is creating a world where everyone has a sense of purpose. As Franklin Roosevelt once said, yours is not the task of making your way in the world, but the task of remaking the world. The empathy of young people that says we should live not just for ourselves, but for the greater good. That's the way forward. From climate change to economic opportunity, be motivated by your duty to build a better world. Because there is nothing more beautiful or worthwhile than working to leave something better for humanity. Purpose is what creates true happiness. As Pandit Nehru said, and I quote, loyal and efficient work is a great cause, even though it may not be immediately recognized. It ultimately bears fruit, unquote. Welcome again, dear students, to the most wonderful years of your life. And remember to keep the spark alive, because we need them in times like this, like the ones that we are going through. With everything suddenly feeling like it's up for grabs, this is your time to seize the initiative. Think about how you, blessed with a world-class education, might act and work when all of this is said and done. We will surely be better off with your leadership, and the world will be stronger than before. Good luck and congratulations again. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your very thought-provoking and stimulating address. We express our deep gratitude for your time. I am sure the students will hold on to every word that you have spoken to them today. I now request Dr. W.S. William, Professor Xavier Institute of Management, to read out the citation conferring the honorary doctorate in business management on Sri Harshpati Singhania.
Good evening. Conferment of honorary doctorate in business management on Sri Harshpati Singhania. Mr. Harshpati Singhania has acquired his MBA degree from University of Massachusetts. He is also an alumnus of Harvard University, USA. Mr. Singhania is a visionary business leader and belongs to one of India's largest industrial groups, JK Organization, and responsible for the paper, dairy, and defense businesses. Mr. Singhania is currently a member of Executive Board of International Commerce, Chamber of Commerce, Paris, where he is involved in supporting the work of the United Nations, the World Trade Organization, and many other intergovernmental bodies on behalf of international business. As Vice Chairman and Managing Director of JK Paper Limited, Mr. Singhania led the company in a path of excellence through application of innovative technologies on one hand and catalyzing social forestry on the other. Mr. Singhania's deep commitment towards environment has resulted in making JK Paper one of the lowest water and power consuming companies in India's wood-based paper sector. He encouraged the company to consistently invest in latest environment-friendly technologies directed to minimize use of finite natural resources. He strongly supported green business practices in all its manufacturing and logistics operations. JK Paper became the first company in Indian paper industry to get Environmental Management Certificate, it's ISO 14001, in 1998. Over the years, JK Paper, under the leadership of Mr. Singhania, won many recognitions, which includes the prestigious Energy Management Systems and Energy Conservation Efficiency Award from CII Hyderabad in 2020, 8th Quality Systems Excellence Award for Industry 2020 by FICCI, and Best Innovative Kaizen Award, Silver Trophy, in 39th CII National Kaizen Competition. Under the leadership of Mr. Singhania, JK Paper undertook pioneering work in social forestry. In the hinterlands of its manufacturing presence, the company procures 75% of the wood from farmers located within 200 kilometers of its two manufacturing plants. This initiative has benefited more than 65,000 farmers. Mr. Singhania actively supported community engagement initiatives for farmers, youth and women in the villages around the plant. These engagements covered education, healthcare and rural infrastructure development. He was deeply committed to align with sustainable development goals. Under his leadership, the company made significant progress in promoting inclusive and sustainable economic growth, resulting in increased share of women and youth in productive employment and education. Under the leadership of Mr. Singhania, JK Paper made the company more resilient to the challenges faced due to COVID-19 pandemic. The company enhanced operational safeguard to ensure safety and well-being of workers in these trying times. The company presented a humane face marked by no forced attrition and no reduction in remuneration for direct employees and contract laborers. During his tenure as president of FICCI, Mr. Singhania worked with policymakers to support MSME and informal enterprises, which he believed can play a vital role in strengthening our economy and as well as creating employment. He emphasized the need to create an urban job guarantee scheme in line with MGNREGA to help build urban infrastructure and create jobs for the urban population. Exim University recognizes the spirit of Maggie's in Mr. Singhania's endeavors in making JK Paper a leader in this sector and bringing economic, social, and environmental prosperity to a very large number of stakeholders associated with the paper industry in our country. Exim University is pleased to award Mr. Harshpati Singhania the degree of Doctor of Business Management, honoris causa, on August 23, 2021 at Bhubaneswar. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor William. I request our Chairman, Father Jerome Kutina, Chairman Emeritus Sri Rajiv Kaul, and Vice Chancellor Father Anthony R. Overy to confer the honorary doctorate on Sri Harshpati Singhania. Congratulations, Dr. Harshpati Singhania. I now request the chief guest to award the 25 years and the 15 years of long service medals to the faculty and staff of the university. Request Father V. Arokya Das, SJ Deputy Registrar Old Campus and Chief Finance Officer, to read out the names.
Good evening, everyone. I stand here on behalf of the administration to announce the names of the long service medalists for the year 2020-21. I call the long service medalists who have completed 25 years of long service in XIM University. They are called based on the alphabetical order. Abhi Chandra Nayak, Abhiram Nayak, Ajay Jenna, Basant Kumar Das, Niranjan Nayak, Sanjay Kumar Nayak. Srileka Pradhan. Now I call the long service medalist who have completed 15 years of long service in XIM University. Babuli Charan Nayak. Daniel Eka. Devendranath Behra. Deshpal Minj. Nalita Nayak. Raju Dhado. Salome Lakda. Work life is not a sprint. It is a marathon that one needs to keep on running and achieve one milestone after the other. We are so proud to have you as part of our work family. We are confident that you will keep the good work for years to come in XIM University. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Father Arakya Das. On behalf of XIM University, a hearty congratulations to you all. Wishing you all the best for continued success. Together, we take pride in your accomplishment and look forward to your commitment to excellence in the years to come. I now request the chief guest to present the medals for academic excellence virtually and request Professor Sridhar Das, Dean Academics, Xavier Institute of Management, to announce their names. Professor Sridhar Das.
I am happy to announce the names of the meritorious students who are being awarded gold medal for their academic excellence in virtual mode. I will announce their names by schools and the programs. School of Human Resource Management. MBA in Human Resource Management, the gold medal for academic excellence. First rank goes to Prakriti Prasanna. Second rank, Miss Manjari Mahato. Third rank, Sanjyoti Agrawal. School of Rural Management, MBA in Rural Management. There is a tie between two first rank holders, Mr. Somesh Mohanty, Mr. Arun Jyoti Sarangi. The third rank goes to Miss Monalisa Mohanty. Father MBD Bogard, gold medal for topper in development ethics seminar course, Miss Monalisa Mohanty. Odisha Jesuit Society, gold medal for best performer in all-rounder category, Mr. Arun Ayappan Kutti. School of Sustainability, MBA in Sustainability Management, Vice Chancellor's medal for best academic performer, Ms. Avani Jha. BSc Honours in Sustainability Development, Vice Chancellor's medal for best academic performer, Ms. Ayushi Dwivedi. School of Human Settlement, MBA in Urban Management and Governance, Vice Chancellor's medal for best academic performer, Ms. Kahini Oja. School of Commerce, Masters in Business Finance, Vice Chancellor's medal for best academic performer, Mr. Vavik Jain. BCom Honours Accounting, Vice Chancellor's medal for best academic performer, Mr. Ratikant Sahu. BCom Honours Finance, Vice Chancellor's medal for the best academic performer, Ms. Drishti Agarwal. BBA Honours HR, Vice Chancellor's medal for best academic performer, Ms. Nivedya Jayaprakash. PBM Honours in Marketing, Vice Chancellor's medal for best academic performer, Ms. Darshana Mishra. School of Communications, BSc in Mass Communication, Vice Chancellor's medal for best academic performer, Ms. Neha Saha. School of Economics, BSc Honours in Economics, Vice Chancellor's medal for best academic performer, Mr. Avilash Barman. School of Computer Science and Engineering, M.Tech in Data Science and Analytics, Vice Chancellor's medal for best academic performer, Mr. Gaurav Hazra. B.Tech in Computer Science and Engineering, Vice Chancellor's medal for best academic performer, Mr. Subhamaya Satpathy. Congratulations to all the Academic Excellence Award winners.
Thank you, Professor Sridhar Das. I now request Professor Neeraj Kumar, Dean Academics, School of Rural Management, to administer the pledge to the graduating students.
Graduating class, please rise to take the pledge. We, the graduating student of XIM University, hereby pledge that we shall always endeavor to be scrupulously honest in the discharge of our duties as managers. That we shall always endeavor to utilize our knowledge for the service of our country and the glory of our university. That in all circumstances, we shall try to uphold the dignity of individual and the integrity of the profession. That we shall, in word and deed, guard against all narrow loyalties and sectarian prejudices, and cherish with pride the basic unity of our country. Thank you. Graduating classes, please take your seat. All faculty members, please rise. On the recommendation of this faculty, the governing board is pleased to confer the Doctor of Philosophy degree on 7 students, 2-year MBA in Human Resource Management on 129 students, 2-year MBA in Rural Management on 108 students, 2-year MBA in Sustainable Management on 26 students, 2-year MBA in Urban Management and Governance on 8 students, 2-year Master's in Business Finance on 14 students, 2 years MA in Mass Communication on 2 students, 2-year MTech in Data Science and Analytics on 5 students, 3-year BCom Accounting Honors on 3 students, 3-year BCom Finance Honors on 22 students, 3-year BBM Human Resource Honors on 13 students, 3-year BBM Marketing Honors on 23 students, 3-year BSc Mass Communication on 18 students, 3-year BSc Economics Honors on 10 students, 3-year BSc Sustainable Development Honors on 8 students, and 4-year BTech in Computer Science and Engineering on 11 students. Faculty members may please sit down. May I now request the Chairman, Chairman Emeritus, and the Vice Chancellor to award the degree.
Thank you, Professor Neeraj Kumar. I request the deans of respective schools to present the graduating classes for the adopted degree virtually. I call on stage Professor Rahul Thakurda to present the doctoral program graduates.
Good evening, everyone. I read out the names of the graduating scholars in the order they have defended their thesis. Biplab Mahapatra, Virginia Sadhana Phillips, Itisri Nayak, Sayam Sampurna Panigrahi, Silu Muduli, Snigdha Choudhury, and Kiran Kotha. I now welcome Professor Moushumi Padhi from School of Human Resource Management to present the graduating scholars.
Good evening, everyone. On behalf of the Dean, School of Human Resource Management, Dr. Andrew Datta, who could not be present physically but is very much with us in spirit, it is my privilege to present before you the graduating batch of MBA in Human Resource Management 2019-21, who are convocating virtually this year. The first three names are in order of merit: Prakriti Prasanna, Manjari Mehto, Sanjyoti Agarwal, Akanksha Sinha, Abhinav Arvind, Abhishek Naik, Airi Pratiksha Ramesh, Ajit Kumar Sahu, Akash Panigrahi, Akshit Jain, Amrit Patnaik, Aranya Chaudhary, Ankita Patra, Anubhav Maiti, Anupreet Misra, Anusya Patnaik, Apratim Mitra, Arvind Das, Augustine Joseph Anthony Michael, Ayushi Sarangi, Chandramoli Kundu, Chinmay Muduli, Diksha Singh, Durgesh Subuddhi, Girja Prasad Padhi, Himani Patel, Ishali Upadhyay, Ishani Mishra, Jita Praharaj, Kedarnath Thakur, Matrusharan Senapati, Mohit Maya Mohanty, Nabanita Das, Nidhi MV, Nilanshu Bohidar, Nikita Behra, Nishita Sinha, Oshin Divan, Piyush Agarwal, Pragya Naidu Papala, Pratik Singh, Pratiksha Das, Priyadarshini Mutaila, Raviteja Myadam, Ritu Kalani, Roshmita M. Wilson, Sai Pradeep Zotink, Sayantan Ghatak, Shalini Rai, Shriyanshu Tiwari, Shriya Valunchkar, Simpi Kalia, Sneha Kamat, Sohan Rai Guru, Soumya Sakshi, Shritam Anupam Mohanty, Sudhanshu Shekhar Baral, Sugirtha SG, Swati Sharma, Talina Mishra, Tuhina Gupta, Umang Sharma, Vandana Swain, Vishal Rautrai, Yasmin Kukul, Akriti Gupta, Ayushi Rajesh Kabra, Abha Lal, Abhipsa Kar, Abhishek Kalyan, Aishwarya Mishra,
आकाश सामल, अलका श्रीवास्तवा, अमित कुमार मोहंती, अनसुईया चक्रवर्ती, अंकुश तालुकदार, अनुज पुंदिर, अनुष्तुप विश्वास, अवनीत सामल, भारत माथुर, कैरलिन रेमन सेक्वेरा, देवाशीष पाढ़ी, दीक्षा खन्ना, दत्तात्रय मिश्रा, गार्गी मलिक, गौरव दास, हरिकृष्णा डीवीएसएस, ईशा संजीव भामरे, ईशान वत्स, जिष्णु चक्रवर्ती, काजोल अग्रवाल, लोपमुद्रा स्वाई, मनोज कुमार दास, मयूराखी दत्ता, मोनक मयूर, मोपर्णा घोषाल, मुदिता घोष, नीतीश कुमार, पल्लवी एन, प्राची प्रज्ञा अगस्ती, प्रतीक कुमार नायक, प्रियंका साहू, रिक विश्वास, ऋतुपर्णा साहा, रुचिस्मिता मोहंती, एस गायत्री, साहिल शर्मा, सार्थक मिश्रा, सैयद ओबैदुल्ला अब्रार, शाश्वत साहू, श्रेया मोहटा, श्रुति पारदर्शी मिश्रा, स्नेहा अग्रवाल, स्निग्धा घुचायत, सौरदीप रॉय, सौरी प्रणीत उदयगिरी, शुभांकर दत्ता, सुगंधा सिंह, स्वाधीना प्रियदर्शनी हाजरा, श्वेता मिश्रा, तन्हा राय, उदित नारायण राउत, वी संकेत, वेदांत रंगम, विदिति भार्गवा, यश्वी केडिया, झलक शशिकांत सावला, गौरव चैटर्जी, अमोल एंड अनिश सूद. कॉन्ग्रेचुलेशंस टू ऑल ऑफ यू. मे आई नाउ रिक्वेस्ट प्रोफेसर नीरज कुमार, Dean, School of Rural Management, to present the graduating class. Thank you.
I take this opportunity to present on behalf of all my faculty colleagues the MBA RM batch 2019-21 batch. The first four names are in the order of merit. So Ms. Mohanty, Arun Jyoti Sarangi, Mona Lisa Mohanty, Arun Appankutti, Abhijit Mishra, Abhishek Chakra, Abhinas Tripathi, Akash Deep Saha, Anjali Yadav, अंकित राज, अनुराग दास, अपर्णा कुसुम, अरुषि मलिक, आशुतोष त्रिपाठी, असित कुमार साहू, अनवा घोष, बीजू मेहर, क्षमा जैन, चिन्मय सोई, देवाशीष दे, ध्रुव सहनी, दिविशा जैन, ज्ञानदीप साहू, हिमांशु शेखर सारंगी, कड़ा सिद्धार्थ आचार्य, किरण कुमार मिश्रा, मानवी उमेश वर्मा, नीली हेमंत कुमार, पूजा दास गुप्ता, प्रदीप्ता कुमार वालर सिंह, प्रज्युत कर, प्रांजल पैक्रिये, प्रतीक्षा सडवाल, पुष्पांजलि मिश्रा, राहुल मोहंती, राहुल पांडे, राजवीर सिंह, रुचिता अग्रवाला, एस आई रमेश रेड्डी, संजीत बिसोई, साफल्य कुमार दास, शाश्वत पटनायक, शाबरी सत्यरूपा, शाश्वती साहू, श्रेया अधिकारी, शुभम अग्रवाल, सोमदत्ता दास, सोमेन पटनायक, शुभम कुमार नंदी, शुभश्री शर्मा, सुनीत दास, सुप्रतीक्षा रथ, शुभ प्रश्ना प्रुस्ती, स्वर्णिमा जयंती, तान्या राव, उमंग कुमार महतो, यशी तिवारी, अभिनव श्रीवास्तव, अभिषेक गुप्ता, अविनाश अभिषेक बरल, अनीस मोहंती, अनुजीत शर्मा, अनुराग त्रिपाठी, अनुरनिता बसु, अर्पिता साबत, अश्वमेखा गिरीश पाए, असीत अनिमेश नायक, अश्विनी कुमार प्रधान, बी अनूप कुमार, विश्वजीत दास, देवश्री देवाशीष, देवाशीष साहू, दिशा मित्रा, एक परना बाग, गोविंद चंदक, हर्षित चौहान, जयचंदन पटनायक, किरण कुमार दास, कौस्तुव रे, मीनू जे नायर, नीलाद्री सान्याल, पूजा दलवानी, प्रगति ईशा,
Prajwal Khandelwal, Praneet Patnayak, Prateek Nayak, Priyanka Bhunia, Rahul Bhoy, Rajat Pandey, Ridham Rana, Ronak Mitra, Saksham Yadav, Sandipana Das, Sankalp Mohanty, Saptarshi Roy, Satyabrat Mohapatra, Shalini Kumari, Siksha Goyal, Shrey Kumar, Shruti Agrawal, Siddharth Dinesh Pai, Soumya Subhra Sahu, Sugandha Kumari, Suraj Kumar Patra, Susri Saloni Mahapatra, Tanu Priya Tiwari, Tanuko Sai Satya Sanjeev Sarath, and Yachana Hota. Congratulations to one and all. Now I request Professor Sutapapati, Dean School of Sustainability, to take the proceeding forward.
Good evening. It's my privilege to present before you the graduating students of MBA in Sustainability Management, Batch 2019-21, who are convocating virtually. The first three names are in order of merit. Avni Jha, Ankita Raut, Dhruv Sehgal, Abhisheka Mahanty, Abhinash Pradhan, Aditya Kiran Dora, Agrini Gulati, Achal Singh, Arushi Ghai, Dibhijit Das, Marushka Bosco D'Souza, Palash Yadav, Pandey Preshita Hirsch, Pratna Chand, Raj Acharya, Samya Lodi, Saurav Suman Rath, Shruti Mathur, Shweta Balchandra Deshpande, Siddhant Sarangi, Soumyaranjan Dalai, Surya Narayan Kar, Swarananda Mahapatra, Swatangshu Shubhankar, Vandana Agarwal, and Rumani Umme. Congratulations, dear students. Now, it's again my privilege to present before you the graduating students of BSc Honours in Sustainable Development, Batch 2018-21, who are convocating virtually. The first three names are in order of merit. Ayushi Dwivedi, Sayantan Mitra, Mahaprasad Rath, Aditya Trivedi, Shisha Barik, Siddharth Panda, Ghazala Nisar, and Swagat Rath. Congratulations to all students. Thank you. May I now request Professor Kajri Mishra, Dean School of Human Settlements, to present students who are graduating from her school.
Thank you, Professor Pathy, and good evening to all. It is a great pleasure to present to you the graduating students of the MBA Urban Management and Governance Program of the batch 2019-21 who are convocating today virtually. The first three names are in order of merit and thereafter by order of roll number. Kahini Oja, Abhipsha Malik, Ajit Kumar Samal, Ashish Kumar Patra, Sadashiva Padhi, Sukumar Das, Viral Arun Kumar Nigam, and Prerna Lenka. Congratulations to you all. I wish you all success in life. I now invite Professor P.K. Mohanty, Dean, School of Commerce, to present the graduating students of his school.
Good evening. I'm happy to present before you the names of graduating class 2019-21 of Master of Business Finance who are being convocated virtually. The first name is the gold medal winner and the rest are as per their roll numbers. Bhavik Jain, Abhinav Goel, Ankita Bhardwaj, Asutosh Panda, Desi Reddy Prithvija Reddy, Debi Prasad Sahu, Gunja Chandak, Pratyansu Sekhar, Saurav Senapati, Salini Kumari, Shubham Garg, Sukriti Garg, Yash Mehrotra, and Ediga Harshvardhan Gaud. Now again, I'm happy to present before you the names of graduating class 2018-21 of Bachelor of Commerce and Bachelor of Business Management who are being convocated virtually. The first four names are the gold medal winners and the rest are as per their roll numbers. Ratikant Sahu, Drishti Agarwal, Nibedya Jayaprakash, Darshana Mishra, Adarsh Kumar Agarwal, Aditi Patra, Anjali Negi, Aliva Patra, Aman Agrawala, Anup Kumar Rath, Anurag Samant, Anvesa Naik, Arshdeep Singh, Aryaman Das, Asutosh Sahu, Ayesha Mishra, Ayush Sabat, Bhavna Panda, Bismay Biswajit Mahapatra, Debi Prasad Panda, Dhiman Minaketan Mishra, Dibyadeep Tripathi, Gagan Barma, Kostubh Mohanty, Mridula Mahapatra, Muskan Bhatia, Neha Patel, Nikunj Modi, Nirmalya Sinha, Nayonika Sahu, PSL Mukti Nath, Palla Bharat Kumar, Pradyumna Thakur, Pratik Agarwal, Preeti Hajra, Pritam Panda, Raj Tilak Prasad, Rakesh Kumar Singh, Redhi Ghosh, Sairaj Prusti Kintali, Smita Patel, Sankalp Rohtagi, Sanket Satpathy, Satyam Agarwal, Sambhavi Das, Shraddha Suman, Sweta Pradhan, Sonia Das, Srinath Andabarapu, Subangi Sahu, Suryans Goenka, Swagat Mishra, Swapnil Panda, Swayam Siddh Rath, Tanmesh Mishra, Taransu Das, Tri Dandapani Hanisha Raj, Vaibhav Bagaria, Yash Bajaj, Praneet Kumar Prusti, and Sahaj Preet Singh Arora. Congratulations to all of you. Now I request Professor V. Vijay Kumar, Dean School of Communications, to present the graduating students of his school. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Professor P.K. Mohanty. Good evening, all. It gives immense pleasure to present the MA Mass Communication 2019-21 batch of graduates, those who are convocating virtually. Gaurav Das and Padmasri Das. Now, I am presenting the BSc Mass Communication 2018-21 batch of graduates, those who are convocating through virtual mode, with Ms. Neha Saha winning the Vice Chancellor Gold Medal for Academic Excellence, followed by her are the graduates presented in the roll number order: Aryaman Daya, Ahana Ghosh, Banvi Sharma, Chetona Bandhopadhyay, Isha Debnath, Pranay Mukherjee, Prithika Mustafi, Priyanga Priyadarshini Das, Raina Joseph, Rajeshwari Das, Rishivans Acharji, Rohan Singh Dev, Ruchi Smita Mishra, Shakti Swarup Mishra, Shanti, Dev Priya Paul, and Archisman Dash of 2017-20 batch. Now I request Professor Guloksi Nath, Dean Academics, School of Economics, to take the proceedings forward.
Good evening. Thank you, Professor Vijay Kumar. It gives me the immense pleasure to present the list of graduating students, BSc Economics honors, who are graduating virtually. The first name is in the order of merit. All other names are in the order of roll numbers. Avilas Burman, Aditya Bhagavati, Diyasa Munian, Devidatta Satpathy, Nandini Das, Raj Gaurav Swami, Silpika Das, Shrestha Majumdar, Lopamudra Chatterjee, and Shreyak Shailendra. Congratulations, students. And now I request Professor Rudramohan Tripathi, Dean Academics, School of Computer Science and Engineering, to take the proceedings further.
Thank you, Professor Goloknath. Good evening, everyone. It is my honor and privilege to present the first graduating batch of M.Tech Data Science Analytics 2019-21, who are receiving their 2 years Master of Technology in Data Science Analytics degree today in this convocation through virtual mode. The first name is the best academic performer, and thereafter all names in accordance to their roll number. Gaurav Hajra, Mehul Kumar Das, Koindrila Mukherjee, Pragyan Prakash Parida, and Pragyan Prayas Parida. Congratulations to all our students. Now, again, it gives me immense pleasure to present the first graduating batch of BTech Computer Science and Engineering 2017-21, who are receiving their 4 years Bachelor of Technology in Computer Science Engineering degree in this convocation through virtual mode. The first name is the best academic performer, and thereafter all names according to their roll number. Shubham Shubhamaya Satpathy, Abhishek Kumar, Asutosh Satpathy, Jasdeep Pratap Singh, Jayasri Biswal, Mrinal Queen Bajpai, Nabhya Nimisa Das, Om Patra, Orona Kumar Neelam Raju, Sanket S. Misra, and Soumya Ranjan Mahapatra, Soumya Ranjan Behera. Sorry. Congratulations to all our students, and wish you all for a bright future ahead. Thank you all.
All the graduating students may please rise. Besides the candidates who are present here, there are others who have been found qualified for the award of the degree but could not attend the convocation. May I now request Chairman Father Jerem Kutina S.J. to confer the degree on behalf of the Board of Governors. Father, please.
By the authority vested in me as the Chairman of the Board of Governors, I award you the Doctor of Philosophy degree, 2-year MBA in Human Resource Management, 2-year MBA in Rural Management, 2-year MBA in Sustainability Management, 2-year MBA in Urban Management and Governance, 2-year Master's in Business Finance, 2-year MA in Mass Communication, 2-year M.Tech in Data Science and Analytics, 3-year BCom Honours in Accounting, 3-year BCom Honours Finance, 3-year BBM Honours HR, 3-year BBM Honours Marketing, 3-year BSc Honours Sustainable Development, 3-year BSc Mass Communications, 3-year BSc Honours Economics, 4-year BTech in Computer Science and Engineering, as the case may be, and I charge that by thought, word, and deed, you prove yourself worthy of the award. Thank you.
Congratulations, dear students. Continue to take the attitude of a student, never too big to ask questions, and never know too much to learn something new. Develop a passion for learning. If you do, you will never cease to grow. Remember, an investment in knowledge pays the best interest. I now request Father S. Anthony Raj, SJ, Deputy Registrar, New Campus, to deliver the vote of thanks.
Distinguished chief guest of the evening and the convocation speaker in the 7th convocation of XIM University, Dr. Harshpati Singhania, Reverend Father Jerome Kutina, Honorable Chairman, Board of Governors, XIM University, respected Sri Rajiv Kaul, Chairman Emeritus, Board of Governors, XIM University, respected members of the Board of Governors, esteemed Vice Chancellor, Reverend Dr. Father Anthony Aruvari, respected Father Registrar, Father Augustine, in whose place I stand now, respected deans, faculty colleagues, my dear staff, friends from the media, dear parents, and my dear students, especially the ones who convocate today. As we come to the end of this solemn occasion, I stand before you to thank you. First and foremost, I thank God, Goddess Almighty, for his, her providence and care that has enabled us to see this day, especially during this COVID pandemic. I thank you, students. It is your day. The 812 students of the 15 programs of 8 schools, the 7 PhD scholars, 697 postgraduates, and 108 undergraduates. You came into our lives. You came into the life of the university 2 years ago, 3 years ago, 4 years ago, as gifts. Now, we gift you all back into the world as you commence your life, your relationships, your career. Farewell. Make us proud. Dear parents and well-wishers, you sent your words to us, to XIM University, and you took the right decision. We are happy with you, happy for you on this day. Thank you for your presence. I thank Dr. Harshpati Singhania, President, All India Management Association, Vice Chairman, Managing Director, JK Paper Limited, the chief guest of the day, the convocation speaker, and from today, our old student, for his presence this evening, for his gracious presence this evening. Known, as we all observed, for his humility and courage and the insightful lessons that he has given us this evening. Thank you, sir. Thank you, respected Sri Rajiv Kaul, Chairman Emeritus, Board of Governors, XIM University, for the direction that you have given us for close to 3 decades, and for your continued motivational direction that you give to us year after year as we reach newer heights. Thank you for bringing Dr. Harshpati Singhania as the chief guest and the convocation speaker this evening. Thank you, Father Jerome Kutina, Honorable Chairman, Board of Governors, for your constant guidance and your words of wisdom this evening. Thank you, Father Anthony Arvuri, our esteemed Vice Chancellor, for your inspiring leadership, and respected Father Registrar Augustine for your meticulous supervision. We also rejoice this evening with all the deans and the faculty. Indeed, we have done a good job of mentoring 812 students. Thank you, respected deans and the faculty, for your presence and your hard work. We are also indebted to the entire administrative team, the IT team, the non-teaching staff, especially those attached to the schools of the convocating students, for your hard work in making this ceremony happen. We thank our friends in the media, print and electronic, team Illuminatics of both the campuses, for covering this event. Thank you, Reena, for anchoring this event so efficiently. Thank you, one and all, who are participating in this seventh convocation of our XIM University in both physical and virtual mode. Continue to be safe, continue to be healthy. God bless you.
Thank you, Father Anthony Raj. Please rise for the national anthem.
I now declare the seventh convocation of XIM University closed. Please rise for the national anthem.
पंजाब सिंध गुजरात मराठा दाढ़ी उत्कल गंगा विंध हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उत्कल जलधि तरंगा सब शुभ नामे जागे सब शुभ आशीष मांगे गावे सब जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे
थैंक यू एवरीवन फॉर योर प्रेजेंस इन ग्रेसिंग द ओकेशन The audience is requested to wait till the academic procession leaves the auditorium.